Lisa and I are at Kintan Ramen. We're both sick, so we come here for our sick food. This is week 10 of the vlog. This week, I'm going to talk a little bit about what inspired me to actually get started in triathlon. So unlike a lot of people who grew up watching the NBC coverage from Kona, I don't ever remember really seeing any of those races when I was growing up. But what I do remember is watching the 2000 Olympics from Sydney. Those were the first Olympics that I really remember watching. I was 11 years old at the time. I have some memories from Atlanta in 96, seeing Donovan Bailey win the 100 meter, or in Nagano in 98, and seeing Canada lose to the Czech Republic in men's hockey in semifinal shootout. But when the 2000 Olympics rolled along, I was really glued to my TV and watching everything that I could. So I remember turning on the TV one morning and seeing men's triathlon. And never heard of triathlon before, and really had no idea what it was at the time. You know, I wasn't a swimmer, I wasn't a cyclist, I wasn't running. So when I saw all the distances that they had to do together, it blew my mind that anyone was actually able to do a 1500 meter swim, and then a 40 kilometer bike, and then a 10 kilometer run. So I was really intrigued, and so I started watching the race, and then I remember the coverage on TV at the time, it would flip back and forth between different sports, and then once they were out on the run, Simon Whitfield started working his way up through the field, and I remember that they stayed on the triathlon a little bit more than going to the other sports, because it looked like he might be able to run up into a podium spot. And sure enough, he did run up into a podium spot, and then he was in second place, and then in the last 500 meters, I remember seeing him sprint past the German and win the race, and that really inspired me. And at that point, I decided that one day I was going to do a triathlon as well. It was really cool to see a Canadian who wasn't expected to do very well win a gold medal, for me to actually be able to watch most of that race and see it happen. It was really, really cool to get to see. And I did decide that at some point I was gonna try and do something like that too. I wanted to do a triathlon. So it was a number of years before I finally got my start in triathlon. It wasn't until 2012 at the Toronto Triathlon Festival. And something that was kind of cool was that Simon Whitfield was actually there, mostly for the publicity, but he was doing a sprint distance as a little tune-up for the London Olympics. But it was really cool that when I did my first triathlon, that person who inspired me to get started in triathlon, Simon Whitfield, was there as well. In that first race at Toronto Triathlon Festival, really didn't show too many signs of promise or potential. I think my time was about 3 hours, 47 minutes for the Olympic distance. I was third last overall. Later on in the year, I did my first half Ironman as well, and I was just under 7 hours. So I wasn't crushing races right out of the gate, but it did motivate me to work hard every day and just consistently try and get faster and just be a little bit better every single day. So that's how that's the story. That's how I got started in triathlon, and I would venture to guess that. That summer day in 2000, that I'm not the only Canadian that Simon Whitfield inspired to get started in the sport. Thanks a lot for watching this week's video. If you like what you see, please click the subscribe button down below. And until next time, happy training.
Oh, this you crazy mother!